A map, as we know, and here we see a late 16th century map of a prefectural and county seat in the middle of Zhejiang province in China. A map is an aggregate. A paper map is an aggregate of different kinds of data. We have physical data, mountains and rivers, infrastructural data, roads and bridges. We have administrative data, the county seat, the prefectural seat, the walls around it. We have religious data, the sites. We have major other kinds of cultural data, private academies and other things on the map for those of you who read Chinese. But a GIS is a bit different, because what a GIS does, it says, let's take all that data that's been aggregated together into a map and let's disaggregate it. Let's treat it as layers. And let's do it with a level of mathematical precision which allows us to correlate particular points on the earth with historical data from the past. To do that, we might begin, for example, with what's called a digital elevation model, a DEM, which is what you're seeing here, of that same place, by the way, that you just saw a minute ago. See the two rivers down in front here? Right? Well, we don't see any rivers yet because we haven't added them on. Let's add them on, and there are two rivers right there. Let's add on some administrative data, a boundary around the prefecture, the prefectural seat, and the county capitals. And that's the essence of GIS. It allows you to layer different kinds of data so that you can ask the question, what's the correlation between the different kinds of data? And here's an easy correlation. You will notice that, by and large, county capitals or administrative seats are on rivers. Higher order administrative seats, like a prefectural capital, which is above the county, are on the junctions of rivers. Right? You'll also notice that they tend to be in valleys, that they are concerned with tax collection. They're basically dividing up arable space to collect taxes. And so we could take a generalization found in one area, a small area in China, and test it against the 300 prefectures in China in the 16th century or 18th century and see how valid it is. And we would find, in fact, that the placement of administrative seats on rivers and junctions of rivers is highly valid.